take it, and Mark didn't snatch it. He absolutely annihilated the field.
So the strength of British gymnastics, thanks to all that lottery support and funding, is now starting to pay dividends, not only picking up senior medals, but also our first gold in the junior ranks earlier today. So the top eight qualifying, of course, from competition one. They will be going in the order of that qualification, and the top qualification scores coming from Nemov and Yovchev, 9.675, both taking an identical score. And of course they've battled it out in many a competition before. If you go back in time, defending European champion Dragulescu, Yovchev taking the world title, and of course Nemov, the silver medalist, just ahead of Yovchev in Sydney 2000. So it really will be a cracking battle.
Yes, it certainly will. If you can imagine 300 meter sprinters all who train at identical times, and it's who can just get the wind behind them on the day and sail to victory. The beckoning floor looked like a freshly mowed bowling green, waiting for our first competitor.
So, Robert Gall, the Hungarian, the lowest qualifier with 9.462, but delighted to have qualified, didn't compete in the all-around competition. And of course, looking to follow in the footsteps of some of the great Romanians who have dominated in the 70s and 80s in European gymnastics from a male perspective. So Robert, the sole Hungarian representative in the two finals we're focusing on here today. Let's see if you can get off to the start that the Hungarian fans are hoping for.
And it's a chance for the real specialists to demonstrate their stuff. And Robert stepping straight out of the floor and giving away a very precious tenth. Handspring, double twisting front, punch front, 1¾ somersault. The men really have to show their versatility in these apparatus finals. It's all about taking high risk and yet being able to execute it with minimum faults, because the high ranking skills will not be counted by the A jury if they have a penalty of up to 0.3. .90 seconds the men are allowed. And that was the buzzer going for the last 10 seconds, but Gall unfortunately stepping out of the area, not in contention with a medal, judging by his difficulty, but it very much depends on what the rest of the field produces under pressure. First tumble, 2½ twist, straight front, and full twisting front. Handspring, straight front, 2 twists, punch front, and punch front, 1¾. So that's a somersault with a dive roll on the end. Quite scary. And then, of course, it's not just tumbling, it's linking together structures of flexibility, strength. There are 5 groups of skills, and every skill, every group rather, must be represented in the exercise.
Well, as we said in the all-around competition, a mistake such as stepping out of the floor means it's almost impossible to claim the gold, and almost identical situation in the individual apparatus. 9.100, Robert Gall delighted to be part of this final. Huge round of applause for the double gold medalist so far from these European Championships, Dan Potra. Now, he will look to put the nightmare of yesterday behind him, because he really did throw the competition wide open by blowing his floor exercise. I think it was an 8.8 that he scored. And this is one of his specialist apparatus. So, oh, and again, almost identical mistake as yesterday. The first tumble out of the floor, and another disappointment for the Romanian.
And you really can't afford to make such huge errors, because really not going that brilliantly well for him. A bit of slackness around the knees there in that spindle. And it very much depends on what difficulty the guys can include in their routines. Because although the hopeful maximum score is 10, not many of them manage to do that. They have to produce 4 A elements, 3 B elements, 3 C elements, which gives them 8.8. And then they have up to 1.2 in bonus points for D, E and super E elements. And just not the man's day. Full twisting double back, coming to grief and sailing out of the area. All of his landings unstable. So I'm afraid I think he has to settle for the 2 gold medals he already has, not to have a third one. And Nadia Comaneci there just giving us a wave.
Well, Monica didn't really go well from the start, and this is the identical tumble combination that almost threw him out of the all-around competition. Of course, in the all-around, they add all the scores together and he clawed his way back in the other five apparatus. This is the individual finals, and he really isn't happy, isn't at home with his floor exercise, or the timing just seems completely out.
Well, his twisting skill, in the first tumble, he dug down his twist, his Rudy, his 1.5 twist went to the left, and he sat into that final tumble. It really was long. He didn't get his hips up. He sat into it, and so it was destined to be over-rotated, and it was a pretty ugly finish for him.
Well, Romania will now look to Dragulescu to bring or maintain their unbeaten track record at these European Championships. Looking up to see how bad and painful it is, and almost brings a smile to his face. 8.637, double gold medalist Dan Potra out of the chase in the floor final with just 6 to go. A chance for Spain and a youngster with his first opportunity to mix it with the big league, Alejandro Barrenechea. Now Barrenechea qualifying with a 9.512.
And that suggests in itself that he's got a pretty big start value. Oh, very nice. An E element starting off with an Arabian 1.75 somersaults and 1.75 twists. 1.5 twists, sorry. Nice 1.5 twist into punch front 1.25. Some nice touches here. And that massively strong. I don't know why he did that straddle, because he's demonstrating that he can't really do an efficient box splits. Perhaps not. Nice press to handstand. Showing the balance, obviously not opting to have a one-legged balance before his dismount. Can balance on one leg or on the hands, as long as they show a balance element. Big, big dismount. Oh, yes. Lovely. Double straight into punch front. So, Barrenechea throwing down the gauntlet to the big guns. He had some fabulous tumbling here. Just take you through it. This is the handspring 1.5 twist into punch front 1.25. We call it a punch because the landing and the takeoff, plyometric, coming straight out of the floor. And then his double leg circles into the spindle in planche. Just look at the extreme flexibility required in the wrists. Showing very good leg extension. And now this, the big dismount. Double layout and punch front. Very, very hard on the ankles and hard on the aerobic system at the end of 1.5 minutes. So a fit guy.
9.200. Well, he seems to be happy with it. Looks a little tough from this side of the commentary box, I have to say. But let's move on from Spain to the first of the two Belarusians. This is Denis Svenkov, just qualifying ahead of the Spaniard Barrenechea. Of course, Belarusia already claiming one medal with a bronze in the team competition.
Favouring twisting. As yet, no double somersault. Good combinations, though. Lovely flares. Ideally, they're looking for those performed on the a tea plate rather than a dinner table. Less travel, the better. Well elevated, simple back somersault with a side exit, and opting to show a one-legged balance, but not demonstrating great flexibility. Double tuck to finish. So as yet, no huge tumbles, but very good combinations in the opening two passes. That just the regular straight somersault with a quarter twist exit. And he managed to pick up a penalty on the hesitation on the landing. Good section. Can you see him lifting off the floor? Flighted flares.
.5, good enough to put the Belarusian into top position at the halfway point. Well, we'll stay with the Belarusians. This is Alexander Kruzlyov. Sixth in the Europeans floor final back in 98, but again a disastrous start.
A lot of them coming to grief. It's very difficult to keep the momentum going. Nice 2.5 twist punch front, full twisting front there. But when they're adding 1.5 twists, easy to go offline. Oh, nice Arabian double. And that a nifty little 1.5 twist jump. Very nice, very innovative. Belarusians doing well to have two qualify for this final. Only two allowed per nation. And what's he going to deliver for the final run? Oh, nicely. Full in, back out. That's two somersaults. Full twist in the first, tuck in the second. But unfortunately, a messed up first tumble. He went out of line, as did Potra. And there it goes. Instability on the landing. So he gets a double whammy because he steps out of the area and loses a tenth and has a very unstable landing and probably loses two. Now this is the final. There's the full twist in the tuck position and exiting with another tuck back somersault. A little bit of an arm circle and he'll lose for that too.
Well, what a shame for Kruzlyov, the best qualifier of the two Belarusians. His teammate, Denis Svenkov, holds on the top position, 9.500 the target. The three big guns left to go from Romania, Bulgaria and Russia. 9.412 goes into second position. Good score considering the error on the first tumble. But now we move on to the pre-event favourites, definitely, and those all lined up for taking the medals. First up from Romania, remember, two golds out of two competitions so far for the Romanians, is a defending European champion, the 21-year-old from Bucharest. This is Marian Dragulescu.
And a very, very powerful gymnast too. Very nice, straight in, full out. Spectacular opening tumble. Speed of his tumbles, full twisting front, straight front, 1.5 twisting front, punch front, 1.75. Beautiful work. Whip, 1.5 twist, full twisting front. Oh, and fingertips very near that line. Just drawing back a little. can just see the power. He moves with extreme speed and nimbleness. Absolutely agile and a very difficult Y balance. The width of the arms, maintaining very good body posture. Single Arabian into the corner. So far, excellent work. This final tumble, the all-important one. It must be big, fast, and still. And he's done it. Brilliant stuff there from Marianne Dragulescu. Whoa. So, who knows who's going to take that medal? He's thrilled with that.
My oh my, he's got every right to be as well, of course. Dragulescu, who took the European title in 2000, then took the silver medal in the Worlds to Yovchev in 2001 in Ghent. And here you see Dragulescu looking to, well, turn the tables on the Bulgarian, really putting the pressure on Bulgaria and Russia next to follow.
And everything is so nimble and accurate and fast. Hardly any execution points here. Just watch his, any part of his body mustn't go out of the line and touch the floor. Even though he was over the line, he didn't actually touch the floor. And this final tumble, a big one. Double twisting double.
9.687, and that really is a big target for Yovchev. And Nemov left to perform. Well, from the defending European champion to the current world champion, the 29-year-old Bulgarian Yordan Yovchev, of course, now residing in Oklahoma, USA. He's already picked up the silver medal in the all-around competition. And now he's looking to take, well, his first European title in the floor.
And he's very good at spotting the corner, but he's only a little guy. So it doesn't travel so far. And there again, the nice Arabian with 1.5 twists. But really, Dragulescu has set a very, very high standard. So I don't know whether these guys are going to be able to overhaul him. That, a very spectacular sequence of flares and handstand in spindle and planche spindle. Wonderful flexibility. Appreciation being oozed from the crowd. Double straight, or is he going to put a twist in it? Double straight and very well spotted. Well, he certainly couldn't have produced any better.
Brilliant performance. Not since 1983 with Petkov have Bulgaria won the European floor title. This man, of course, taking the gold in the Worlds. But and of course the bronze in the Olympics, and this is one of those classic moments, Monica, where it's lovely to be able to say, I think we'll leave that one to the judges.
Yes, I just have a sneaky feeling that Dragulescu had just too much difficulty for Yovchev to overhaul. It just depends on how they perceive the artistry. But he really didn't give much for the A panel
it's
to
enough.
Do.
Enough! Oh, that is tremendous. 9.762. Well, Monica, you're absolutely right. The judges obviously enjoying the artistry because it looked to be a more technical performance from Dragulescu. So far, so good for the world champion. One to go. And, of course, a former European champion, a former Olympic champion, the silver medalist from Sydney in 2002. This is Nemov, Russia's most successful gymnast of all time. 6 European Championship medals to his name, and this is going to be a tough one to make it 7.
Very nice full twisting double layout, and for a big man, a very big skill. And if the judges like artistry, then here's the man. Oh, beautiful work, absolutely beautiful. He's precise right down to the extension of his fingers and toes. Really is a pleasure to watch. And just look at that. Even choreographed to face the crowd at the end. perfect. Everything with such precision and aesthetically, unquestionably the best so far. Well.
Amazing. Fantastic stuff. Well, many people have started to question whether Nemov is able to maintain his best, now married, a family man, rather than the wild, outgoing character that he was a few years ago. He first entertained us in Eurosport in this kind of style in the Atlanta Olympics back in 96. Of course, he took the silver in the floor in the Sydney Games of 2000. But for me, Monica, this is Nemov back to his best with that little bit of entertainment at the end as well.
It's beautiful work, absolutely beautiful work, and the judges don't have an easy shout there. But Nemov, great entertainer, made a recent visit to Great Britain to open the fantastic new Benfield Centre in Newcastle-upon-Tyne. And from all accounts, he was just absolutely wonderful. Gave a spectacular performance and a gentleman through and through.
So, well, make your own mind up at home very quickly.
Yes,
Russia or Bulgaria,
yes, yes.
And it's Russia. 9.825, a massive score under the new code. First position for Nemov, the European floor champion, regaining his title that he took back in 1998. Yovchev, the first to congratulate Nemov, taking the silver for Bulgaria. And Marian Dragulescu, who we had thought had laid down an unbelievable gauntlet for the others to better, having to settle for the bronze. As we expected, a thrilling final, but it is the last competitor of all, Alexei Nemov of Russia, who takes the gold with a scintillating performance.
Absolutely fantastic. And really, there's an archaic of a belief up in the crowd. Brilliant stuff for Nemov. Isn't it great to see him back up there?
Nemov back to his best as Yovchev confirmed the silver medalist. Dragulescu 3, Savinkov 4, Kruzilov of Belarus 5, Baranchea 6, Gol 7, and the disappointing Dan Potra, who took the all-around gold yesterday, having to settle for 8th position. The Russians hadn't taken a gold until this point of the men's European Artistic Championships. They had to draw on one of their biggest names of all time, Alexei Nemov, to take the gold in the men's floor. We're going to take a quick break from the action. Of course, we'll be back with more. The final and the best 8 in Europe of the pommel horse. Another final not to be missed. Don't go away. Us. In the men's individual apparatus finals, we've just seen a thrilling opener. If you've just joined us live, well, be sure to catch up with our highlights programmes later this evening and throughout the early part of this week, because Nemov has just picked up a magnificent gold in the men's floor. Russia's first gold of these Europeans, as we now turn to the pommel horse finals. The top 8 qualifiers from competition 1, Vlasos Maras, Savinkov goes again for Belarusia, Runa Alexanderson for Iceland, 24-year-old from Barcelona, Victor Cano. Suchi, the European vault champion in his first of 2 finals. Krukov, 99, world champion in pommel horse. Wisnari of Italy, second best qualifier. But the man to watch out for, and must be possibly the biggest favourite of all the individual apparatus finals, is Marius Uzica. Uzica, of course, the defending European champion, the Olympic champion, and, of course, the world champion from 2001 in Ghent last year. So the best going last of all, Maras, the lowest of the qualifiers, working our way through to the hot favourite, Uzica. Uzica is also looking to equal the record of Zoltan Magyar and Guzogi, who have each won the European pommel horse title 3 times. And for Marius, taking it the first time in 1994, then 2 years ago in Bremen. And of course, the 26-year-old Monica really is the hot favourite. It will take something incredibly special or a disaster from Marius for him not to retain his European title.
Yes, on paper he is by far the best, but of course we all know what the pressure can be like, and his string of titles does tell us that he can cope with the pressure. And I'm sure he can. But it's great to see that right up behind him is an Italian. The Italians have figured in the junior European, but they haven't figured at all in the senior. So wouldn't it be nice for to have a renaissance of Italian senior men?
Well, the Italians eighth in the team competition. Busnardi qualifying with a 9.675 to Urzica's 9.825. But as you quite rightly said, Monica, he really has got the lot, as our Marius Urzica. Sydney, the Olympic gold, Europeans in 2000, Pommel gold and the Worlds, the major tournament of last season. Now, Marius Urzica will get the benefit, and it obviously seems to be a benefit if we take Nemo's performance in the floor of watching all seven performances before he has to take. And of course, this potentially could be Romania's third gold medal after taking gold in the men's team competition, and Dan Potra taking the gold in the men's all-around here yesterday. Quick reminder, and I hate to repeat myself, but I'm sure you'll agree why Britain has won a gold here at these European Championships. In the junior event, Mark Freeman has claimed the gold in great style in the junior men's rings earlier today. And again, another clear demonstration that British gymnastics is on the rise, as with many European nations we've been following over the past couple of weeks, with the women's competitions here in Patras last weekend, and of course, a bronze medal for Beth Tweddle in the women's individual apparatus finals there, and the men's competition this weekend.
And I think that whilst we watch some of these experts, particularly Marius Urzica, what we must bear in mind is the self-management of the man. Look at him. He is so incredibly fit. There's more to it than just turning up at the gym and training. The lifestyle management, getting to bed at the right time, not eating and drinking too much for years and years and years, really managing himself extremely well. And the gold medals are the reward for that management.
So just a few moments away from the start of the Pommel Horse European Individual Apparatus Finals here in Patras, Greece. Those of you wondering, Patras, it's around about 200 kilometres west of Athens. But of course, important European Championships here for Greece. Almost a dress rehearsal for the forthcoming Summer Olympic Games in 2004. And as for the world's best gymnasts, well, a busy period leading up to those Summer Olympic Games. We have a World Championships later this year in Hungary. Then a big World Championships in 2003 in Indianapolis, in the United States of America, of course, before the big one of 2004. And the host nation has provided us with some pretty impressive young stars that they're clearly blooding for those 2004 games. But here is the man to watch out for, Marius Urzica. Just by warming up, he seems to be psyching out the opposition. Of course, this man won his first European pommel horse title now some 8 years ago. And to me, he looks as quick and as confident as ever.
And the judges have a very difficult task. There are two panels. There's an A panel, a jury of two men and a chairman, and they have to decide the start value. That is, that they have to dissect the difficulty and evaluate the routine. And then the B jury, six men, they work on execution, and the top and the bottom scores of the execution jury are averaged.
Well, the new star of Greek athletics, particularly from a male perspective, and particularly at these European Championships, is Vlasios Maras, the world high bar champion. So this is his second final of the day, and he's one of the hot favourites to take the European gold in the high bar. A good performance here will give him a boost of confidence going into that final event of today's action. The 19-year-old from Athens, seventh in the all-around competition here yesterday, continues to make his mark after stepping up from the junior ranks at the last European Championships.
And the judges looking for five group elements, one leg swings, two leg circles, spindles, which he's doing now, turning on one pommel, travel with the back to the apparatus, and unfortunately, and he drops his shoulders in despair, a repeat of yesterday in the all-around finals where he came off the apparatus. He's young and he's under a great deal of pressure. A very, very difficult piece of apparatus to master. And remember, at 19, he's quite an incredible superstar, just giving his triceps a little rub. Obviously, they cramp and fatigue very easily. enormous strength required on this piece, but he's got 30 seconds to get back onto the apparatus and complete the exercise. He was in full swing. Now he's traveling with his back and then into the shears, double lead circles, and then the dismount phase, handstand with a quarter turn. Not the most difficult of dismounts, but once you've lost the pendulum action of the legs on pommels, it is very, very difficult to regenerate the power of the swing and keep the whole thing going. So often on the shears, the men just clip their knees on the apparatus. This isn't deductible. And they have to travel on and over, and the most difficult moves are traveling from one end of the apparatus to the other over the pommels. And there, the half spindle into the handstand dismount. At one time, handstand dismounts weren't permitted, but an 8.875 and a rather morose morass.
Understandably so, as Denis Savinkov just missing the medals in the men's floor, coming in fourth there for Belarus, who took the bronze in the team competition. Now again, Savinkov, second top qualifier, second last qualifier, I should say, 9.525. He's looking to better from his qualification round to make this final.
Now travelling with a reverse, then with his back. Quiet groups, spindling on one handle, on two hands, changing back to front to the apparatus, into the flares, and then, oops, he was trying a very difficult dismount. I suspect he was trying to totally travel from one end to the other, put his hands in between the pommels, didn't quite get his shoulder over his wrist and bent the arm and almost fell. But difficult work. Incredibly difficult with closed hands on the pommels to keep the hips high. And one of the great innovators of these travels, Magyar, Zoltán Magyar, who Nick mentioned, a former European champion. And the flares were actually first innovated on floor by Kurt Thomas, an American gymnast, and they were transferred onto the pommel horse. But there, tucking down from the dismount, and that would have cost him a pretty package. 9.375, and he'll have lost a couple of tenths on that.
Well, he goes into first position, but of course the big guns coming last of all. Let's continue to move up. Ninth in the all-around competition, which is a brilliant performance for Iceland's top gymnast. This is Runar Alexandersson. And again, could be a surprise here, looking to try and pick off a bronze medal. Clearly the pressure starting to show in this very tough pommel horse final.
Very nice travel, stepping between and on the pommels. See, with broad shoulders, so difficult to keep the arms straight and get the hips around. And once you've got elbow bend, it's irretrievable. There, the left elbow went, and center of mass drops, and there's nothing that can be done about it. Carrying on with the travel now in flares. Transferring to the shears. Oh, and coming to grief again on the hop turn. And what a great pity for Iceland's debut into a European final. But the man shows that he is quality. He's physical talent enough to get into the final, but a little bit daunted by the pressure, and he's probably done this routine so many times it's untrue, but obviously the pressure has got to him. And this, a beautiful travel, lovely flexibility, reminiscent of Bila Zertchev, the world champion, who was a particular master at this area on pummels. And then on a relatively simple area, the hop change, he came to grief. But a good travelling dismount, just skirting the pummel there with his forearm. And
shame, as you said. A real shame. Good to see the smaller nations make their mark, and Runa doing so well to take a top 10 placing in the all-around competition. The first of the three finalists of eight in this pommel horse, all having a major catastrophe and big mishap, a tumble or a serious mistake. Now, 9.375 is the best, so the competition, of course, still wide open. We've still to see a performer make their mark. 8.175 for Alexanderson, going into third position. Now, from Iceland to Spain, 24-year-old out of Barcelona. Again, another competitor who did exceptionally well in the all-around competition. Victor Cano finishing in eighth spot yesterday. And again, looking to try and take advantage, well, of a difficult start for the first three competitors. Really, anybody's medals for the taking thus far.
Yeah, the final four, and the pressure is huge. Feet are a little bit low, but he's going very well. Very difficult work. Nice straight arm, good. Oh yes, spectacular. Good transition, and yet again. Oh. Just not quite getting the legs closed on the one and a half pirouette into the floor on the dismount, but every section well completed. And he went from strength to strength. At first I thought his feet were dipping a little bit, but really managing to keep the circular action going well. Lovely straight arms, beautiful technique. And this very, very strong on the arms. If you notice when the gymnasts come off, they're massaging their triceps because it's just so difficult on the upper arms. This is why they develop such huge upper bodies. But just not getting his legs together quite enough and causing his shoulders to dip down on the end, and that was the only perceivable fault.
9.562 goes into first position. Well, 9.562, the Spaniard sets the mark. Not since 57 have Spain won a European pommel horse title. Joachim Blum. Now, Siku for Romania, the 24-year-old, defends his European vault championship title later this afternoon. But for now, the pommel horse, 9.637 is qualifying score. And if he can pick that off again here in the final, he'll comfortably go into the lead.
This really is a pressure piece of apparatus. Breathing very important to oxygenate the muscles. And when the adrenaline is flowing and when the heart rate lifts, very, very difficult to monitor. Good breathing and good rhythm. Oh, yes. And the Romanians really are showing that they are responding outstandingly to the big pressure in this event. And he's grateful for that performance, very grateful. Just a little bit of pike as he passes over the handles, the center of gravity drops a little, but very difficult back travel. Just notice the extreme flexibility required on the wrists as they change level. Imagine having to walk along something. It's like walking up and down stairs. And that, a lovely dismount. Shoulders right over the wrists. Great exercise there. 9.662 takes him into first place. Two more to go, so he's sure of a bronze.
We have Russia, Italy and Romania. Now let's go to the sole Russian qualifier, Nikolai Krukov, third in the Europeans and the Worlds in 98 and 99, just 23 years of age, but a lot of experience upon those young shoulders. And again, the target, 9.662.
My mistake, there's three gymnasts to go. Oh, difficult work, very difficult. Difficult to transfer from that skill, because often they take a little bit of weight on the elbows on the scale spindle. Accelerating now, very, very fast travel, good spindle there, nice. Oh dear. And he's off. So perhaps my saying that Suchi was certain of a bronze was the kiss of death on Krukov. But there. Weight, the shoulders behind the hips, the elbow bent, and as I've already said, irretrievable. Impossible to recover from. The balance totally gone. Essentially a piece of apparatus of distribution of body weight. The shoulders must be right over the center of the pommel horse during all of the work. So he'll be gutted.
Well, it's good news for Romania, because Suchi now guaranteed a medal, because Nikolai Krukov will be penalized. Seemed to clip the pommel very early on with his feet, a couple of times right at the end, the horse. But then here's where it all started to go wrong, almost running away with himself. Was going at a fantastic speed, Monica, but like you say, once the hips drop, there really is no escape.
Yeah, this is very difficult. A little bit of elbow bend there, but the transfer, he worked so well. Lovely traveling dismount. But it gets even more difficult than that, and Rozica probably demonstrates that.
So fourth position, which means with just two to go, Suchi is guaranteed a medal. Krukov 9.087. Busnari and Rozica. Now this really is a test for the Italian. Eighth in the team competition, just 25 years of age, Alberto Busnari. Well, we'll know that all he needs to do is put in a similar score to his performance in the qualifiers, and there's a silver medal for the taking. And again, it will be a record for Italy. So this really is a test of this man's career to date.
Yes, not since the 60s, Caramanucci and Minichelli, the great stars of yesteryear. Can he handle the pressure? So far, so good. Lovely centralized balance, shoulders staying right over the apparatus. Head must remain still. He's keeping focused. Traveling flares, dismount coming. Oops. Oh dear. Good, but so nearly came to grief at the end. Shoulder angle closed pitifully on the dismount, so be very difficult for him to maintain that 9.625 that he scored in the qualifying round, but went very well and very, very difficult exercise. Maximum start value. Oops, that slow motion just manifest a little bit of leg split. So the execution panel, panel B, will be the ones that decide the fate of Busnari.
Well, 9.637, all smiles for the Italian, because he knows it's good enough for silver or a bronze. One competitor to go, and that really is a lucky escape. He felt like a couple of seconds longer and the troubles really would have opened up. Now, this is the man, the Olympic champion, the world champion, and the defending European champion, Marius Rozica. He's won just about everything the sport can throw at him in the pommel horse, but what he's now looking to do is equal the records of the greats of yesteryear, Zoltán Magyar and Gazzoghi, three times European pommel horse champion, this for Rozica's third European gold.
And it doesn't matter how many times the routines have been trained in the gym. There's nothing quite like the pressure that this man is under at the moment, but just look at that. So difficult and so explosive. Keeping the rhythm going. Oh, yes. Clean as a whistle, and he's done enough and he knows it.
Well, the king of the pommel, really an outstanding performance. No butterflies or nerves whatsoever. And surely that is enough to equal a couple of the greats of former artistic gymnastics and maintain that fantastic record. Mario Surzica, 26 years of age, played a fantastic role in captaining the Romanian team. But when it's down to individual honours, an electrifying performance once again.
And of course, some of the great innovators, Gutsoki and Magyar, the motivators of the present day standard, both Hungarians, and it's a shame that we haven't got a Hungarian in the final. But just look at the niftiness of his spindles on that one pommel. Very, very difficult work. He's slender, Y-shaped. And there were tiny little errors in execution, but yes, he's done enough. 9-8-1-2, and he's equaled the greats.
Well, a great performance from Marius Urzica, and of course, a 1-2 for Romania, taking the gold and the silver. Romania now claiming its fourth medal of these Europeans, but most importantly, its third gold. Marius Urzica in sparkling form, successfully defending his European title, now unbeaten since Bremen in major championship competition. And as we said at the beginning of this men's individual final, equaling the record of Zoltán Magyar and Gazogi, who each won the European pommel title three times in their career. And of course, Urzica, I'm sure, and that kind of form will go on to the Worlds this year, the Worlds next year, and who knows, even try and successfully defend his Olympic title. 9.812, Urzica takes gold in the pommel horse final, Suciu taking the silver, a 1-2 for Romania, and Busnari, a very pleasing bronze for the Italian team, third. Cano just outside the medals, 4, Savenkov 5, Krukov 6, Maras and Alexanderson of Greece and Iceland down in 7th and 8th after a tough opening start to the pommel. Look out for the Greek star, the youngster at just 19 years of age in the high bar final, which we'll be bringing you later on this evening. But Romania continues to be the dominating force at these European Championships, claiming its third gold from 4, with another 4 gold medals to be decided. And of course, we'll be bringing you highlights of the rest of the action from these championships later on today. Congratulations to Marius Urzica, gold medalist in the men's pommel horse. And of course, if you missed it, well, it was an absolute cracker, I have to say, to Alexei Nemov, taking the gold in the men's floor final.
C'était du beau travail de force, mais l'on va voir peut-être encore plus fort dans les combinaisons. Et peut-être avec Andrea Coppolino, digne successeur de Yuri Keki. Yuri Keki qui avait gagné, quant à lui, 4 fois de suite le titre européen à cet agrès.
Belle entrée de Coppolino.
La croix de fer renversée est bien placée aussi, les épaules bien dans le plan des anneaux.
La croix de fer.
Planche libre à nouveau. Tenue très longtemps. Grand tour en lune.
C'est bien ce que fait Andrea Coppolino, 9662 lors des qualifications. Et peut-être encore mieux maintenant. Bonne sortie, lui aussi.
C'est également un sans faute.
Est-ce que ce sera suffisant pour détrôner l'Ukrainien Sergei Vialtsev de la tête du classement? C'est une autre histoire. Parce que Vialtsev a réalisé juste avant lui un excellent mouvement.
Il sera très très difficile de les départager. Voyez la croix de fer bien positionnée. On note la tête parfaitement dégagée sur la croix de fer. Les forces ont été très très bien tenues. Et cette sortie parfaitement exécutée, stabilisée, rien à dire.
La note 9712 et la première place. Excellente performance d'Andrea Coppolino. Presque assuré de monter sur le podium. Presque parce qu'il en reste 3. Il en reste 3 et non des moindres à passer aux anneaux. À commencer par ce superbe athlète Sylvester Xolani, le Hongrois. L'un des tout grands spécialistes mondiaux des anneaux. Pas de Français, bien sûr, dans cette finale des anneaux. Les Français se sont qualifiés aux barres parallèles et à la barre fixe. Florent Marais, Yann Kuchra au parallèle, Dimitri Karbanenko et Florent Marais de nouveau, qui a réalisé la meilleure performance lors des qualifications.
Champion olympique des anneaux, cela fait 10 ans que Solani gagne des médailles à cet agrès. Oh, il y a la série de force.
Magnifique. Vous pouvez faire l'étude anatomique des bras, des avant-bras, des épaules chez Xolani.
Croix de fer renversée, aucun balancé des anneaux. Position parfaite.
Oh là là, magnifique.
Équilibre par la planche, bras fléchis. Grand tour en lune. Soleil passé et la sortie double arrière tendue. Bien stabilisé également comme les concurrents précédents.
Devrait prendre la tête avec cet exercice Sylvester Xolani. Sans doute l'exercice le plus pur depuis le début. Regardez cette musculature.
Là, il aurait peut-être pu tenir une petite seconde de plus pour impressionner. Et cela devrait être de toute manière suffisant pour prendre la première place du classement intermédiaire dans cette finale très très disputée, qui, comme nous l'avions prédit, Patrick, va crescendo dans les forces, notamment.
Très très gros niveau. La note de Xolani, 9725. Il prend la tête devant Andrea Coppolino et le russe, l'ukrainien Vialtsev. Yordan Yevtsev maintenant pour essayer de passer devant Xolani. Il a déjà une médaille d'argent au sol, une médaille d'argent au concours général individuel. Il avait terminé avec la deuxième note des qualifications, Yordan Yevtsev. Beaucoup, beaucoup d'expérience. Est-ce qu'il n'est pas fatigué par le concours général individuel? Il revient de blessure. C'est déjà extraordinaire de le voir à un tel niveau de compétitivité. Regardez ça.
Maîtrise, force, puissance, croix de fer équerre suivi de croix de fer équilibre. Position avion.
Là, il faut être fort quand même.
Et il remonte jusqu'à la position avion. Petit coup de tête. Pour Jordan Joycef, aucun tremblement non plus. Et la sortie, il met une vrille supplémentaire.
Une vrille. Petit sursaut à la réception, mais peut-être un tout petit peu plus de difficultés techniques pour Xolani.
Super, j'espère qu'à ce niveau, le petit sursaut.
Ah, sa sortie était un peu plus complexe.
Et oui, et donc un petit peu plus difficile aussi à maîtriser dans sa stabilité. Jordan Joycef, très encouragé par le public. Il est le tenant du titre mondial. Justement devant Sylvester Xolani.
Super niveau sur cette finale des anneaux, des championnats d'Europe. Et là on voit le morceau de bravoure de l'exercice de Yordan Yevtsev qui vit aux États-Unis.
Normalement, cela devrait faire l'affaire.
Belle sortie. Et juste un petit quelque chose à la réception. Et il prend la tête, 9,750. Formidable performance de Yevtchev, qui sera de toute façon au minimum, une fois encore, médaille d'argent. Il reste un seul spécialiste des anneaux dans cette finale, et non des moindres, follement applaudi par le public. Dimosthenis Stampakos, le grec. Il avait obtenu la note de 9,700 lors des qualifications. Le leader Yordan Joychev en est déjà à 9,750. Il va donc falloir sortir le très très grand jeu.
Il est très 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 fort et en plus il a l'avantage de travailler à domicile. Voilà, Avion. Croit te faire renverser. Nouvel Avion. Grand tour en lune. Doublé. Attention, les anneaux balancent légèrement. C'est un petit peu moins net. Soleil passé, la sortie de l'arrière tendue avec un petit sursaut. Non, je ne pense pas. Oui, je ne pense pas que cela fasse l'affaire. Les anneaux, on a vu, ils balançaient très très légèrement. Or, il est bien évidemment essentiel à ce niveau d'en maîtriser parfaitement le balancer. Il n'est pas réjoui complètement de sa performance. En plus, il n'a pas pilé sa chute.
Quel niveau sur cette finale des anneaux, extraordinaire.
Trembler légèrement.
Va attendre la note de Stampakos et vous dire que bien pour le résultat des Français aux barres parallèles et à la barre fixe, savoir si Florent Marais, Karbanenko ou Kuchera sont sur les podiums. Nous vous donnons rendez-vous dans Stade 2 présenté par Christian Prudhomme. Dans tout le sport que vous pouvez suivre tout à l'heure, présenté par Laurent Lia, la note de Dimosthenis Stampakos qui devrait sortir incessamment sous peu. .9737, il est deuxième, Yevtchev, champion d'Europe, devant Stampakos et Sylvester Xolani. Ça fait plaisir pour Yevtchev qui avait déjà deux médailles d'argent à son actif. Il touche enfin à l'or, champion d'Europe aux anneaux. Rendez-vous donc tout à l'heure pour les parallèles et la fixe et les Français dans Stade 2 avec Christian Prudhomme et TLS avec Laurent Luya. A bientôt pour de nouvelles aventures et à tout à l'heure pour ceux qui aiment la gym. Au revoir. La chinoise qui fait